boards up on there, anybody take parks before? That's geometric probability, because it deals with the area of those little things that you gotta get, okay? And so, is that geometry, right? You find the area of something, geometry, okay? Alright, so what y'all did a second ago, okay, meaning yesterday, you did a probability, and basically, you just put it with the number of successes on top of the total number of outcomes, okay? Here's geometric probability, okay, very similar to that. The probability that a given event occurs in a given length or area of a geometric figure. Like the example I gave on the darts, okay? So just write the geometric probability definition. You don't have to write the one at the top. The probability that a given event occurs in a given length or area. You have to be volume. We're gonna do some right now. We're gonna just do three examples. So that's why these notes are super easy. Three examples. Everybody got the definition down? Anybody still writing? Geometric probability. Alright, first example, just put example one. And then draw these, geometric figure, which is a segment with four points on it. Draw. P, Q, R, and S, and then you've got some specific lengths there. Between P and Q, it represents 7 units. Between Q and R, it represents 13 units. And between R and S, it represents 5 units. Okay? Now, to write A, B, and C, you don't have to write the whole sentence. It's real simple. Okay, for A, I want you to tell me the probability, so put capital P, and then parentheses, the point is going to land on QR, and then you can just put a blank like that, okay? For B, we're going to find the probability that the point is not on QP, okay? So you don't have to write a full sentence down, you just write the probability of that. And then the last one, we're going to find the probability that the point is on QP or Argus. Okay? Alright, don't blur out answers. I'm going to ask you guys. Okay? So, most of these are in fractions. So, tell me what the numerator would be for A, the probability that the point is on QR. What's the numerator, Moses? What's the numerator going to be? For the first one, QR. 13 is correct. That's the numerator. What's the denominator, Zahar? 25 is correct. And then you always want to be able to reduce that if you can, but can we on this one?
No.
Okay. Okay, second one. What's the probability the point is not on QP? Give me the numerator, Aiden. 18. So 18 units, that's not QP. Good. And then what's the denominator here? 21, 25. Okay. Can you reduce? And then the last one, what is the probability the point is on QP or RS? What's the numerator? Adam, the numerator.
13.
Close. Oh, thanks for being quiet, guys. Thanks for being quiet, guys. What's the denominator, Parker? 25. Okay. All right, so that's using quiet. That's using probability of a segment. You're going to be given a word problem on your assignment. Where you're going to probably be, it might be the best idea to draw a segment to represent certain things, okay? All right, let's go to the next example, right? Example two, and draw that picture. Right, example two, and draw that picture. Same thing. I'm going to call on you, no word out, people. What is the probability that you'll land in region B? What's the numerator, Kendall? What's the denominator, Sunny? What's the denominator? 360. Okay, so here we got some bigger numbers, so you can reduce that to that. You can even put a percent. Can somebody with a calculator give me the percent? It's just a calculator for calculus. 11 divided by 36. 30.5%. Let's round to the tens. So six. 30.6%. Okay, you'll see a lot of percentages on the answer key. It's because you're going to be working with some crazy guesses. Okay. All right, last one for this spinner. What's the probability that it's an A or C? What's the numerator? Matthew, what's the numerator? So what do you get? or what did Parker get, since you won't try to do it yourself? Okay, see, now he says I'm different. See that, can I get a second on that one? It's 178, the numerator. I see something, Jamie, what do you get for the numerator, Gina? 415, what do you get?
Oh, wait.
450? 450.
I got the present, thank you.
468.
Oh, it's because I messed up on the part, I'm real crazy.
Alright, what's the denominator, Rico? Same as the other one.
Thank you, I just like that.
Okay, give me that percent, guys, into the tens place, please.
32.1%.
Alright. If it doesn't specify, then yes. Alright, what is the probability that the point is in one of the squares? Give me the numerator, David, I'm calling you. Probability that it's in one of the squares. What's the numerator? No, what's the numerator, Arch? 200. Okay. Now, think about it, in one of the squares, let's say you threw a dart, okay? You can land in that one, right? Okay? Or? If you can land in that, you can still land in that one, right? Okay? We should throw a dart at this, right? No, it's a great idea, the floppy. And the numerator, I mean, the denominator is still 14. Okay, so, 1.7 is 1%, though.
14.3.
Alright, and then the last one, what's the probability that the point is in the rectangle, but it is not in each of the interstates? Tell me how, what is your number? Tell me how you get the numerator. So how much is the calculator on this one? 750?
Oh, no, that's 1.3.
750, right, so you take 1400, and you subtract 150 and 200, which is how much? 650, and so you get 750. Alright, good, so 750 is your numerator, and then you still have 1400 as your. Good, so that's how you get your numerator, you subtract. Then, what is the percent?